Scoring categories allow you to do a lot more than just traditional scoring, which can sometimes be arbitrary. Let's say, for example, you have different products on your website. One being a camera, one being a tablet, and one being shoes. How do you know if a customer is interested in the tablet, the camera, or the shoes? And how do you quickly pass that information over to your sales reps? That's where scoring categories become very, very valuable. So how do you set up these scoring categories? So, first thing you do, go to the admin section, go to automation settings, hit scoring. Now, you see a button right here, it says add scoring category. Click on that, and here you set up the different scoring categories you would like. So, set up camera. And of course, shoes. Great, now you have three scoring categories set up. Now how do you utilize scoring categories now that you have them set up? Simple. A quick way to utilize scoring categories is through page actions. So if you go to the page actions section, you have a new page action called shoes pricing. Now, go ahead and say, give them a score of 10 points. Of course, this is traditionally how you use scoring and page actions, but now the new thing you get to do is apply a scoring category. So let's say you give the 10 points to the shoe scoring category. Now, when you go to a prospect's record, not only you can see they have 10 points, but you will see it broken up by what scoring categories they have. This information can also be floated up to the Salesforce contact or opportunity or lead object. This is very useful because now your sales reps can have insights to what product or what scoring category or what service your customer or prospect is more interested in. This allows your sales reps to have more poignant and relative conversations with your customers.